guys, if we could pick all of you as number one, you know we would. You know we would. But we can't. It can be only one. And the winner of whatever this was called. Mixing contest.
Artist in Residency at Metalworks Studios.
2023.
Hi, my name's Craig McDonald, and I'm the campus director here at Metalworks Institute. I'm really excited to bring to you this term's Artist in Residency. We are featuring Cory Hotline, a cosmic collision of rock, funk, pop, and disco.
Like doing my thing, no one's really paying attention to me, you know?
Follow your heart.
Psycho Killer.
Yeah.
Ballroom Blitz.
Yeah, yeah, we got a new song that we just wrote. That, we play.
That called Overdue?
It's called Overdue.
Okay, I thought he called it that because he wanted it to be like...
No,
it's not a one that's already out.
Can't find it.
Okay, find it.
Doesn't make sense.
You're the first one to do lights for it.
We literally just wrote it like on Sunday.
So yeah. Okay. Brand new.
Hey, you know, I can do that.
Just make it cool.
Yeah, we'll do.
Consider that.
Consider that. It has to be cool.
It's got to be cool.
All right.
Artist in Residency today, Metalworks Institute, Metalworks Studios, and Metalworks Production Group are proud to present Cory Hotline!
Alright, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna play some songs you know, we're gonna play some songs you don't know, and you guys are gonna like it. You didn't pay anything, so don't complain. And I think we're gonna have a really wonderful time today.
Are you ready to rock?
Yeah!
Thank you so much for coming to this mandatory concert. We really appreciate it.
My question is, for all these lovely people who are thinking about doing a mix for that song for you, what are you guys looking for?
More vocals.
Yeah, reference tracks for that one.
I was listening to a lot of Doobie Brothers.
Michael McDonald there.
Yeah,
I think like, or like the Eagles.
But modern.
Yeah, modern. Like
Clarity, the boom in the back.
More bad.
Lobotomy, rock and roll, make it sound good.
So you didn't eat breakfast, eh?
I ate breakfast.
You can't not eat this. Yeah. Seriously?
So again, welcome everyone. Welcome to the band, guys. Thanks for coming back and being a part of this. The students had a blast doing the mix and obviously the live sound and the lights during the live show. Once we get through all the mixes, then what we'll do is we'll go privately into the soundproof floor and you guys will pick what you believe to be the best mix for that best suits your guys' needs. And then the owner or owners of that mix will be invited to be assistant engineers on your next session here at Metalworks.
All right, let's rip it.
So this is Oscar, Emily, Caden.
Sounds like K-O-E.
K-O-E, yeah, Axel. Axel, just behind you guys. Dylan Davis, well, he's sitting right behind you. Oscar, Mila, Addy, Will.
Yes,
I think that's that crew.
Jaden, he's sitting on the couch right behind you guys.
Oh yeah, yeah, bump it.
Whoa.
This sounds blah.
That sounds blah. Yeah,
yeah. When my weather balmy. That's pretty intimidating.
From what I'm hearing, it's pretty good, balance-wise.
Yeah, my first comment as soon as it started was like, yeah, I love the bass, it's
I thought like the kick may have been a bit loud, but the bass-kick relationship.
Well, yeah, that was on point. Was good. Yeah.
I think considering it was live, it sounded awesome. Didn't really sound live to me. Guitar sound was cool, sounded like Johnny Marr. I really liked that. It was like, oh, that's not really what Connor sounds like. So that's what I'm talking about, like taking chances. I thought that was cool.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah, that vocal, little vocal trick at the end, little like walking down the hallway. Yeah. Deal. I like that a lot too. That was really cool.
I really love that you like took a chance on that ending because I feel like it definitely needs something. Like, we just worked out the arrangement a couple days before we came in to play that song, so it needs something arrangement wise for sure. So I really appreciated that you like gave some treatment to the ending there.
Great job. Thank you very much. As a bass player, thank you very much.
I liked the lead keys were nice and loud throughout the whole thing, which I enjoyed.
Our first time ever mixing instruments like that. Yeah. So I live set.
Great job. Like, more from like hip-hop stuff.
Yeah, so like live set instruments, like, that's all new.
We don't really know
us.
Exactly what live musicians want to hear.
Takes time. You know, I was thinking while I was listening to the drum mix specifically that I was like, ooh, the kick is like massive and the snare sounds like and I was like, oh, it sounds like a hip hop loop, like it does more than a like rock.
You can kind of hear the hip hop.
Thank you.
I could hear like the little bits of character and textures that I was playing that I was like, oh, maybe I did play it that boring, you know? So
big chorus feels big and nice, I wrote. So that's good.
I like it in that sounds nice and live. The biggest difference to me is like the cymbals bring out so much more energy.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
And that sparkle.
Great job overall on the drum mix. I really liked it as a bass player. I got excited by it. I was like, this made me want to play. I felt that there was something happening with the hi-hat. So I don't know if that was like an EQ thing or whether it was the nature of how it was mic'd or like.
At the very last minute, I took out the hi-hat track. Because it was so loud.
Wow.
And at the very last minute, I was like, then I took it out. And then the day after I was finished, I heard it ticking at me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I was like, it's driving me. I couldn't sleep all night, actually. Like, I was having dreams about EQ and it ticking out. Yeah. I was hoping you wouldn't mention it.
Some of the tracks weren't as gained up as they should have been. So they had to do a lot of work in terms of they got a raw mix.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right? So.
Well, let's just say again that you guys all did an amazing job so far. Like, it sounds great. We're just like really like. Nitpicking,
because
that's what we're here for.
Yeah, absolutely.
Sorry that
you almost
got
away with
that.
I'm glad you took the time with every job. That was awesome. Thanks so much.
Can I say one thing?
Yeah.
Mixing live band is like the hardest way to mix anything. So that's like the hardest thing you can possibly
do.
Into everything. Everyone's kind of sometimes playing slop or whatever. It's not like
it's not an easy mix.
Yeah, it's not an easy mix. Yeah. Like that's the hardest thing.
All right, so guys, what we're gonna do now? We're gonna take the band. We're gonna go onto the live floor. When we come back in, hope they're gonna have a selected winner for the mix competition.
Honestly, they're all great. Connor said the right thing, and that's the hardest thing to make sound good. It was really interesting to hear who wanted it to sound live and who wanted it to sound studio and who wasn't quite sure where they wanted to land, you know?
So what would you guys say?
Yeah.
Let's hear it.
Honestly, I was like, oh yeah, this sounds like people who produce hip-hop trying to
that's what they did with the drum. Totally. It was a very interesting approach. Right? Yeah. Like, they actually did well with what they were going for.
Yeah.
I was confused by it at first. I was like,
I want to give an honorable mention of the first mix, the KOE mix. Actually.
The first one of the last was
maybe the week before.
That's actually compared to where all brand new students.
Wow.
The fact that they were in the studio, like that's what they went for. It was impressive because I think they nailed that. Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
The two live sounding ones I thought were the ones that had the most energy. Number three and number five.
Yeah. What's his deal?
His understanding?
His history of this stuff. So he did PSS, right? PSS. So he did a year of business, a year of studio, went interned for a year, and then came back to do the mixing and mastering program because he wanted to be more well-rounded. So
it seems like all of us agree. Everyone did a really, really good job. Like Connor was saying earlier, mixing live sound for recorded format is like the hardest thing to be mixing, and you guys did a really, really good job. We were saying out there, it was just super interesting to see everybody's different approach to it, and who thought, oh, let's make it sound live, and who thought, let's make it sound studio, and who thought, let's make it sound somewhere in between, or whatever. And I was just saying to Ben a second ago, like, honestly, we were expecting to come in here and hear a bunch of mixes that sounded pretty much the same and go like, well, I don't know. Like, but there was like tons of personality in them, which I thought was really, really cool. And every single mix got its own little honorable mention while we were talking, saying, oh, I really like the way they did this. We thought this was really interesting, blah, 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 blah. And guys, if we could pick all of you as number one, you know we would. You know we would. But we can't. There can be only one. And the winner. Oh. Whatever this was called. Mixing contest.
Artist in Residency at Metalworks Studios.
2023.
Early.
Early.
Mr. Double D. My man. We all basically, when we were out there, were like, the thing that we all wanted to hear the most was live. And I think if we had been split on that, it would have really changed what we went with, because you know, that first group, you guys did like a really, really good job making it sound like super, super clean. But we all were just like, nah, we want that energy that feels like the live band, which we thought yours did like really, really well. Mm-hmm. And guys, everyone did great. You're all super talented. If this was the top five, I'm sure the rest were also great. You know, you guys are doing good work here. You should all be proud of yourselves. I know I am. And thanks so much. Yeah, I don't know. You guys have a good time.
Congratulations on winning, man.
Oh, thank you.
How do you feel?
It feels great. It feels really good. Spent a lot of time on it, and I felt like the mix turned out really well. It's kind of terrifying to hear it through those speakers because I hadn't heard it from them, but as soon as I heard it, I felt really good about it. Spent a lot of time with the teachers to like get a lot of good guidance, and it helps to have great teachers.
How do you feel, because this is the second time that you've kind of gotten into the, like the top two or three, but this is the first time you're actually taking the crown, so how does that make you feel?
The first one wasn't really my element, and I was still learning too, and I am still learning, and that's the great thing about mixing is that you're always learning. This one was more in my wheelhouse as far as like mixing live. And editing, and it's all just kind of came together with this one. And I love the natural instruments and the connection you feel with that, the live element. It's just, it resonates with me. So I felt really good about it.
Well, good job. You did really good.
Yeah, thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, here's what we're going to do. We're going to play some songs you know. We're going to play some songs you don't know, and you guys are going to like it. You didn't pay anything, so don't complain. And I think we're gonna have a really wonderful time today. Are you ready to rock?
Yeah!
Good. Excellent. We too are ready to rock.
Ah!
Thank you so much.